Hello, my name is Imre Vellinga. I started with studying sociology. After my studies, I started working in the financial sector for a couple of years with a focus on responsible investment. After that, I could combine financing and my interest in sociology at Society Impact. I work here for 4 years now, and I live in The Hague. Hello everyone, thank you for watching. Unfortunately, we're not together in China now for the presentation. Two years ago, we were in Amsterdam, where I also gave a presentation, as I will do today. But now we're in The Hague at the Office of Society Impact, where I work as a social dealmaker. At Society Impact, we're a non-profit, and we have the ambition to solve social issues. And we do this by three ways. First is we come up with new ideas of new concepts where we work together, public and private, and to involve a wide variety of stakeholders to jointly come up with new ideas and to be involved in the social impact, social issues at hand. So this is a real wide variety. This can go about integration, about homes for homelessness. This can go about health issues. This can be people who are poor or in debt. And by doing so, we also always focus on new ways of financing the initiatives that we come up with. Secondly, we are an intermediary for ideas that exist or social enterprises that have good ideas but who are in need of a network or who need financing. We help them with that. And thirdly, we do a lot of research on social impact of these enterprises or projects who help vulnerable communities. And I will elaborate more on that later. So I think that most you've read during your studies and also the lectures you might have been watching were about greenhouses or architecture or sustainable building. I don't know much about that. So my focus will be on businesses, social enterprises, and innovative ways of financing the good ideas you come up with for your project plans in the World Greenhouse Challenge. I will start by saying something about different kinds of investors and companies. Then I will zoom in on social enterprises, where we distinct between social enterprises that make products and social enterprises that deliver a service to a community. On the last group, I will also give some examples and also discuss how this can be financed. To start with the company and investor spectrum, you can distinguish between the traditional businesses whose sole and main purpose is to make profit and to make money. They don't really care about society, or at least they don't show. And they basically just want to make money. Then there's also a group of companies that want to make money, but not at all costs. So we call them they do no harm companies. They do their best to make as much profit as possible, but also they have a strict CSR, corporate social responsibility policy in place. Then, and that will be the main group I will talk about today, are the social entrepreneurs. They don't just want to make money, but just as important is to have a positive impact on society. And then as a fourth category, there are the non-profits or the NGOs, the charities who just want to do well. This also has consequences for the investors for these organizations or the way they get their money. So the traditional bank companies, they will have traditional investors like regular banks or other investors who also share the purpose of making money. Then there are the impact investors who want both a profit but also intend to have a positive impact on the society through their investments. And then thirdly, there are the charities or the philanthropists or donations who will just contribute to organizations by giving them money without expecting any return. So as I said, I will now focus on the group of social entrepreneurs. So the entrepreneurs who would like to gain a positive impact on society, but also are looking for ways to financing that. Here we distinguish between two groups. On the one hand, we have the enterprises that produce a product, and there are the group of enterprises who deliver a service. For the product social entrepreneurs, you can think of, I'm not sure if you're aware with that, but in the Netherlands we have a company called Tony Chocoloni. Their ambition is to produce chocolate without being involved in slave labor or free labor. And at the end of the day, they produce chocolate bars who they're trying to sell. By doing so, they have a real straightforward business case. So they have the social problem, they make a product, and they sell their product. And by selling it, they can run their operation. And this can go for many different products or companies as well. So if you'd like to say that Tesla, for instance, is a social enterprise, they make cars, they sell the cars, and if the price of the car is right, then they will have a small profit, or at least they won't make any losses. In the screen now, you'll probably see a sheet of some revenue streams. These are the ways, well, on the product side, you can make money. And I think for you, this can be interesting when you look at your business case or at your project plan for your greenhouse. You have different ways of making money. So let's say that you want to grow tomatoes somewhere on the ground of this project. Well, you can just sell them, and if the price is right, then your business case is correct. But for instance, you could also rent out rooms, or you can have a subscription fee for people who get monthly access to, well, whatever you think is necessary or what is a good idea. Or you can, for instance, use space for advertisement and ask money for that. And in all those ways, you can attract money and make your own business case. But these are all more classic business models. But what do you do if you can't use the traditional business models for your target audience or for the people you want to reach out to? So what if these traditional revenue streams are not applicable? Because as I just said, you have an audience that can't pay for it by themselves. Well, firstly, of course, you can look for a donor, or maybe you know someone or an organization who have money for a project like yours. Or you can think of something else. Because the service you will deliver to this group, for instance, so people are living on the street and they don't have a job. And because they live on the street, they are more often sick. So they need to go to the hospital more often. Maybe they cause problems in the area. So the police has to come and show up. And all these are costs that are being made and paid for, usually by the government. So if you want to help this group somewhere, there will be a saving, because money doesn't have to be spent on this target group. And this is what we try to do with social impact bonds, for instance, to make this money free to be spent on the social enterprise. And you can think of many issues, for instance, employment. So what if someone doesn't have a job? In the Netherlands and in many other countries, people will then get a social welfare monthly fee. but also because they're unemployed, they don't contribute to society and they will pay less taxes. This can be on poverty and debt, this can be on loneliness, education, illiteracy. So there are many issues at hand, and I'm sure you can come up with many more also with focused on your project plan and the region you want to focus on. So as I said, the impact of these solutions will have will lead to cost benefits somewhere. In the slides you now see, it's maybe it looks a little bit complicated, but what we've done there, it's called a rate card, and it looks at different benefits or outcomes of a project that will also match some sort of price and some sort of saving. Perhaps in the Q&A we can discuss some examples you come up with, so we can brainstorm a little bit together what you can think of and how you could do this. The basis is that somewhere someone will benefit, and this might be the government, this might be an insurance company, this might be an employer, this might be even a neighborhood association or whatever, but just someone, and depending on the issue and the place where you are. And this will be explained in a video we will now show. This video focuses especially on health, but what goes for health is applicable also for some of the issues I just explained earlier, and I think you'll see how it works.
Hoe kan preventie, innovatie en gezondheidswinst in de zorg gefinancierd worden? De baten van investeringen komen immers vaak bij andere partijen terecht dan de zorgondernemers. Bij verzekeraars, gemeenten of werkgevers. Steeds vaker voeren maatschappelijke zorgondernemers op een financieel rendabele wijze innovatieve projecten uit die leiden tot gezondheidswinst. Deze ondernemers lopen echter tegen knelpunten aan. De budgetten zijn versnipperd, de financiële prikkels in het zorgsysteem belemmeren innovatie en soms staan regels in de weg. Met een Health Impact Bond kunnen we bewezen preventieve projecten wel financieren en opschalen. De HIP is een innovatief financieringsinstrument waarbij private investeerders een interventie betalen om een zorgprobleem op te lossen. Het is echter geen obligatie, maar een prestatiecontract tussen investeerder, ondernemer en een probleemeigenaar zoals een verzekeraar of overheid. Hoe werkt het? Een investeerder financiert een bewezen effectieve interventie. Met deze interventie wordt gezondheidswinst geboekt. De te behalen resultaten worden vooraf in een contract vastgesteld. Naast de impact realiseert de interventie ook kostenbesparingen in de zorg. Behaalt de ondernemer de resultaten, dan krijgt de investeerder zijn investering met vooraf afgesproken rendement terug. Deze wordt betaald door de partij bij wie de besparingen zijn gevallen. Een onafhankelijke beoordelaar toetst het succes. Een intermediair begeleidt en bewaakt het proces. Een Health Impact Bond beloont dus alleen prestaties. Zijn de prestaties niet behaald, dan ligt het financiële risico bij de investeerder. Een win-win-win situatie. De zorgondernemer werkt met een duurzaam verdienmodel aan opschaling. De investeerder realiseert financieel en sociaal rendement. En bij de probleemeigenaar, overheid of zorgverzekeraar worden besparingen gerealiseerd. Samen maken we meer impact. Doet u mee?
So to summarize what you've just seen, on this slide you will you can see what it looks like. In blue you will see the impact entrepreneur who delivers a service to some sort of target audience. Then this will lead to a cost saving for the beneficiaries. So this can be a municipality, an insurance company, employer, and depending on the situation, many other people. But the impact entrepreneur needs money, so this will be paid for or invested in by philanthropists or impact investors. And in the end, if everything works out according to plan, the impact investor gets his return out of the savings of the beneficiary. I will illustrate the working of social impact bond by an example. The first example I'll give is called Work After Detention. This is a real social impact bond that is implemented in the Netherlands, and it's about recidivism. So in the Netherlands, annually 30,000 people leave prison, but within 2 years, almost half of it, 50%, returns to prison. We thought this was a large and problematic situation that can be changed, because we knew by studies and by interviews and by academic research that some factors have an impact on recidivism, like finding a job, having an education, having a house. So what could we do to solve this problem? Well, together with a group of stakeholders, social entrepreneurs, banks, philanthropists, and of course the government, we came up with a social impact bond to address this. And the focus was on training and education within prison to make sure that when they came out of prison, this would help them to find a job and hopefully don't break the law anymore. What you can see on this slide is what the impact is of it and what we expected as an outcome. Well, firstly, of course, and the most important thing was that the ex-prisoners had a better living situation, but also that they would find a job sooner than they would normally. And this would lead to a saving on welfare costs. And also we thought that this would, well, at least our goal was that this would lead to 10% less recidivism. This all leads to social savings, and these social savings of municipalities and of the national government are used to pay for extra training, extra education, and extra job coaching for this group. To discuss another example of a real social impact bond within the Netherlands, and I must say, and I'll share a link with you as well, where you can see an overview of many impact bonds worldwide, so to give more food for thought, and well, perhaps you can find inspiration also for your own project plan. The second impact bond I will discuss is called Social Hospital. It's the name of a social entrepreneur, and they focus on multi-problem families. In the sheet now you see a price tag of what this social entrepreneur find out and researched would cost annually per year on costs of insurance companies, of the municipality and of the national government. So you see cost of welfare, the psychologist, parent support, social work, and this all adds up to almost 100,000 euros a year. Now they started by visiting these families to discuss this with them, and they were all really shocked because they thought, it's terrible, there are so many institutions and organizations involved in our situation, but still we don't see any solution and we're not really being helped. And now we also see that we are so expensive, but how can this be? Well, they found a solution for this, and that is a personal plan for each family, how they can be helped. Sometimes the main problem is that they're in debt, and so with a small budget coming from the social enterprise, they're helped out with their money problems and they can move on. And they brought down the list of organizations that are involved in the with these multi-problem families from approximately 15,000 down to 15 down to 5 per family. Together with the municipality of The Hague, an insurance company, and the social entrepreneur Society Impact made a social impact bond. And as you can see on the slide, the investment was 1.3 million euros, and we expect a return of 4.75 million. So these families are better off. We measure if they're more happy, if they're more satisfied, and if they really have the idea that they're being helped with their real problems. And the municipality saves money that they can spend on other social issues. So now, what can you do with this? Well, for the main part of your project plan, probably you will make houses or you will sell products or whatever you can think of. But maybe you also want to have more social impact next to the sustainability impact by building a green farm and doing everything with state-of-the-art technique and things like that. But if you also want to have social enterprise, you can mix of social impact, you can mix those financing instruments, and so also look at social impact bonds. But then there are a few questions you should ask yourself. What is your target population? So whom are you gonna help? What do you want to achieve? So what do you want to achieve in terms of, do you want to provide housing for homelessness? Do you want to help sick people to get better? Or maybe you want to prevent that people get sick? How do you do this? What idea do you come up? And perhaps you can think of some smart ways of involving people without a job in farming within your greenhouse or things like that. Who will benefit from this? Is this the municipality? Is this the community as a whole? Are there some employers who will benefit from this? And what then, in the end, are the expected impact and results? And how do they translate to monetizable real cash at some place? Then if you want to do this, I think three steps will be important. The first will be to make an impact scan. An impact scan we use as an overview to write down what the intervention is and what the expected results will be. Then based on the results and the expected results, you can make a social cost-benefit analysis. And this is where you research, let's say that people who are now unemployed will find a job. Then, for instance, in the Netherlands, the social welfare for unemployed people is around 1,000 euros a month. So if you help them to find a job sooner than expected, you will save 1,000 euros a month. Well, in that way, you should look at your ambition or your goal as well to how can you translate the impact you want to make to social cost-benefit analysis. And thirdly, you use all this information to make a social business case, which you will use to engage important stakeholders. So these are, of course, the target audience. How do you gonna involve them? Do you expect of them? How are you gonna help them? But also the beneficiaries and investors you will need to make this work and make a real deal. Thank you for watching. This was my presentation. I hope it was valuable for you and that you can use it to come up with a good project plan, not just to focus on sustainability issues, but also to help the local community a little bit. Now we'll go to the Q&A. If you have any other questions that will not be addressed, I will send some links to websites, and also you can write me an email. Thank you for watching.